students, welcome to the poetry class. Today we are going to learn The Lake Isle of Innisfree, written by William Butler Yeats. William Butler Yeats is a noted poet and playwright. He was born in Dublin, Ireland in 1865 and received an education in both Dublin and London. Throughout his career, he was deeply invested in helping Ireland reclaim a literary culture of its own, free from English influence. When Yeats wrote The Lake Isle of Innisfree in 1888, his journey into poetry had just begun. He wouldn't even have anything published for a year. The Lake Isle of Innisfree is perhaps the best known of all Yeats poems. It has been a popular choice of anthologies since it was first published in 1890 and has made Innisfree a tiny island in Low Gill in County Sligo, Ireland, now a place of pilgrimage. This green and watery landscape is where the young Yeats spent time as a child, and the idyllic imagery remains strong in his memory. He wrote the poem when he was in his early 20s, stuck in the metropolis of London, homesick, struggling to get his name known and his poems out in suitable form. The setting of the poem. The Lake Isle of Innisfree is a real place near the coast of Ireland. It is not inhabited and is on Lough Gill, a lake in County Sligo. The lake itself is approximately 5.5 miles in length and 1.5 miles wide, so it is very small. Yeats would go to Sligo as a child on vacations, so it was a good memory for him. It is a quiet place. Think of somewhere you know and love, a woodsy place where you can hear the frogs and birds, a place to get away. That might be your Innisfree, the Lake Isle of Innisfree. I will arise and go now, and go to Innisfree, and a small cabin built there, of clay and wattles made. 9 bean rows will I have there, a hive for the honey bee, and live alone in the bee-loved glade. Through this stanza, the speaker expresses an intention to get up and go to a small island in Ireland called Innisfree. On the island, the speaker wishes to build a modest cabin out of clay and bundled twigs. The poet hopes to plant 9 rows of beans in a clearing which will buzz with the sound of honeybees tending to a nearby hive. And I shall have some peace there, for peace comes dropping slow, dropping from the veils of the morning to where the cricket sings, their midnights all a glimmer, and noon a purple glow, and evening full of the linnet's wings. Through these lines, the speaker believes that this setting promises peace, which will emerge slowly as the hazy mist of the morning falls to the earth, where crickets chirp. On the island, light flickers beautifully in the middle of the night and glows with a purple hue at midday, while little birds flutter about in the evenings. I will arise and go now, for always night and day. I hear lake water lapping with low sounds by the shore, while I stand on the roadway or on the pavement's grey, I hear it in the deep heart's core. The poet reiterates an intent to get up and go to Innisfree, explaining that all day and all night, the poet imagines hearing the lake's waves breaking on the island's shore. As the speaker stands on roads or other paved places, that imagined lake sound resonates deep within the speaker's heart. He wants to go to Innisfree, though he is standing somewhere else amidst the crowd. In this poem, William Butler Yeats has used few poetic devices. First and foremost, alliteration. Alliteration is the repetition of a consonant sound in two or more closely placed words. The instances of alliteration in the poem are hive, honeybee. The sound H is repeated. Lake, lapping, low. The sound L is repeated. And he is also following a rhyme scheme. The rhyme scheme of the poem is AB, AB. He also uses repetition in his poem. For example, I will arise and go now is repeated in stanza 1 and 3. He also uses personification when he says morning in the second stanza. And he also uses metaphor in where clouds are compared to veils. Lake Isle of Innisfree by William Butler Yeats. Thank you.